والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين حبيبي وحبيب إله العالمين أبي القاسم محمد.
اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد
وعلى أهل بيته الطيبين الطاهرين المعصومين الذين ذهب الله عنهم الرجس وطهرهم تطهيرا.
اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد.
قال الله العلي العظيم في كتاب الكريم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم وما أمروا إلا ليعبدوا الله مخلصين له الدين حنفاء ويقيموا الصلاة ويؤتوا الزكاة وذلك دين القيم صدق الله العلي العظيم. صلوات
اللهم صل على
محمد. In the beginning, I would like to offer my well wishes and congratulations to Ahlul Bayt alayhim as-salam for the birth anniversary of our 12th Imam, Al-Imam Sahib al-Asri wa-Zaman, Ruhi wa Arwah al-Alamina li Turbati Maqdamihi al-Fida, and also to offer my congratulations to the Muslim in the world, and especially the Shia of Ahlul Bayt alayhim as-salam and around the world, and especially to this community. And I pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He help us and give us the tawfiq where we will be able to shape our life according to the teaching of this great Imam, inshallah. Before we proceed to talk about this great personality, I would like to talk about what the month of Sha'ban is offering for us as a Muslims. In the month of Sha'ban, as you know, in the hadith of Ahlul Bayt alayhim as-salam, is one of the important months in Islam. The same way as the month before this month, which is Rajab. And Rajab is known as one of the four chosen months. And the Rajab also is known as Shahrul Ummah, the month that Allah chose to be the month of the Ummah. But the month of Rajab is the month of Ummah, and the month of Sha'ban is known as Shahru Nabiyyukum, as the month of the Prophet. Then the month of Ramadan comes to be the month of Allah. So you have the month of the Ummah, the month of the Prophet, and the month of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In this month of Rajab, there are so many things that Allah and Ahlul Bayt through the narration have taught us to do. And the same thing applies in the month of Sha'ban as well. But one thing that I want us to keep in mind, it's amazing. In the month of Sha'ban, is one of the very few months in the whole year that is the only months of birth and no shahada. Versus the month of Muharram, which is the month of shahada and no birth. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has chosen the month of Sha'ban for Ahlul Bayt alayhim as-salam. Now look at the month of Sha'ban. How many mawalids we have, birthdays we have. The first one is the birth of Imam Hussein alayhi salam. The second that follows is the birth of Abu al-Fadl al-Abbas. The third that follows in the same month is the birth of Imam Ali ibn al-Hussein Zain al-Abidin. The one that follows also is the month that Ali al-Akbar is born. And the month of Sha'ban also Zainab alayhi salam is born in.
MashaAllah.
You know, Aqmar, Ahlul Bayt, these are the stars of Ahlul Bayt alayhi salam. All of this in the month of Sha'ban, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have chosen. An amazing, brothers and sisters, you have to understand, this is not just random. That Allah chose the birth of Imam Hussein, the birth of Abu al-Fadl al-Abbas, the birth of Imam Zain al-Abidin to be in the same month. And these are the people who also around each other in the month of Muharram, in the Karbala. Right? They were all together in the month, they all have these tragedies together, and their birthday also comes in the same month also. It's not something random, it's something that was meant to be by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because you go to the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells you that nothing in this universe happened randomly. No. وَمَا تَسْكُتُ مِنْ وَرَكَةٍ إِلَّا يَعْلَمُهَا. Allah says, no leaf falls from a tree unless we know why and when. Everything is documented by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So everything that happened in the month of Sha'ban is documented and is known by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But what is important here, brothers and sisters, is in the month of Sha'ban, what are the things we are encouraged to do? That's what I wanted to emphasize before we go to talk about the birth of Imam. In the month of Sha'ban, what are the recommendations from Ahlul Bayt for us? That the month of Sha'ban comes, I'm still living. Well, you will read Dua Sha'baniyya, which the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam taught us, and it's recommended to read after wajib prayer, right? You see in that, it talks about what the Prophet does in the month of Sha'ban. وَهَذَا شَهْرُ نَبِيُّكَ الَّذِي كَانَ يَدْعَبُ فِيهِ صِيَامِهِ. Tells you about some of the things the Prophet does, used to do in the month of Sha'ban. One of them, he constantly fasts in the month of Sha'ban. He constantly keeps the night within this month more than the other months. That is the Prophet. So Ahlul Bayt, they taught us so many things to do in the month of Sha'ban. Then I want to share with you five of those things. Just five, there are many, but just five, and you can pick any one of these five. And just practice it. So that you don't let the month of Sha'ban comes and ends, and you don't get the benefit of this month. Because remember, this Sha'ban, nobody knows if next Sha'ban is going to come and we're still alive. So many people were here last year, Sha'ban, but they're not here this year. So it's a time that to take opportunity of this month and do the a'mal that Ahlul Bayt encourages to do. Number one, from the Ahlul Bayt alayhi wasalam, the things that are recommended for us in this month is kathratul istighfar. Doing a lot of istighfar. That in Islam, istighfar generally is encouraged. But in this month, it's more and highly recommended that a person takes a time that in the month of Sha'ban, let your dhikr to be istighfar. And you know, istighfar also is very important in Islam. And istighfar is the cause of why we still living according to the Quran in Surah An-Nisa. You know, Allah told us in the Quran, there are two reasons why you, the Ummah of Prophet Muhammad, you don't get what we call adab istisali. Adab which punish the entire nation. The previous Prophet, their people were punished. Prophet Salah alayhi salam, Prophet Noah alayhi salam, their people were punished. All of them. Right? But why is it that today we are not being punished? Quran tells us two reasons. Number one, it said, وَمَا كَانَ اللَّهُ مُعَذِّبَهُمْ وَأَنْتَ فِيهِمْ. The reason is, our dear Prophet is still here. وَمَا كَانَ اللَّهُ مُعَذِّبَهُمْ وَأَنْتَ يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهُ فِيهِمْ. That's one. The reason is, Allah said, out of respect for you, Ya Rasulullah, being among this ummah, whether being alive or deceased, it doesn't make any difference. Your existence is the reason why I'm not going to punish them. That is one. Number two, what is the reason? وَمَا كَانَ اللَّهُ مُعَذِّبَهُمْ وَهُمْ يَسْتَغْفِرُونَ Allah said, we are not going to punish them. As long as there are people who do istighfar. Now, من هم أهل الاستغفار? When he asked the tafsir, they say, أهل الاستغفار are the أهل البيت عليهم السلام. They are the ones no night passes unless they say, أستغفر الله لأمة محمد. Night doesn't pass unless they do istighfar. They ask Allah, and there's a riwayat from Ahlul Bayt alayhi salam that many people came to the Imams and they asked them, Ya Abna Rasulullah, make dua for me. And then the Imam says, Awala afal, don't you think I do? So okay for that? I said, Ma min laylatin, no night passes, illa wa da'awna lakum, wa staghfarna li dhunub. No night passes unless we do istighfar for your sins. Now this istighfar, the Quran tells us, is the reason of our existence in this world. Because otherwise you look in this world, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala punished Prophet Noah, his people, because of disobedience. He punished the people of Lut for one sin. And this is happening today. You think, mashallah, the people of Prophet Muhammad, they're so cute. So Allah spared them because they look so handsome and beautiful, guys. So Quran tells you the reason is two. One is the existence of our Prophet, and the second is what? Is istighfar. Now you go to the Quran, the importance of istighfar comes when Allah tells Rasulullah, Ya Rasulullah, there are three things I want you to do. Allah is telling the Prophet, Ya Rasulullah, always remember to do at-tahmid. Alhamdulillah. That is one. Number two, remember to do tasbih. Subhanallah. The third one, istighfar. It says, إِذَا جَاءَ نَصْرُ اللَّهِ وَالْفَتْحِ وَرَأَيْتَ النَّاسَ يَدْخُلُونَ فِي دِينِ اللَّهِ فَسَبِّحْ بِحَمْدِ وَاسْتَغْفِرْ Allah is telling us, Ya Rasul, do istighfar. Now you go to the Quran, and Surah Nuh, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us the benefit and the power of istighfar. فَقُلْتُ اسْتَغْفِرُوا رَبَّكُمْ إِنَّهُ كَانَ غَفَارًا يُرْسِلِ السَّمَاءَ عَلَيْكُمْ مِدْرَارًا وَيُمْدِدْكُمْ بِأَمْوَالٍ وَبَنِينَ وَيَجْعَلْ لَكُمْ جَنَّاتٍ وَيَجْعَلْ لَكُمْ أَنْهَارًا Just the istighfar. That is to tell us the importance of istighfar. Now, in the month of Sha'ban, can I do any istighfar that I want, or there is specific istighfar? Ahlul Bayt, they taught us two specific istighfar. Number one, it's very short. What is it? Astaghfirullah wa as'aluhu at-tawbah. That's the first one. Very short. Astaghfirullah. I seek forgiveness from Allah, and to him I repent. That's the shortest one. Alright? That is one. The second one is a little longer than the second one. It says, Astaghfirullah alladhi la ilaha illa hu al-hayyu al-qayyum ar-rahman ar-rahim. That's one. Another one. Astaghfirullah alladhi la ilaha illa hu. And then it says, ar-rahman الرحيم الحي القيوم وأتوب إليه الله أكبر. What is the difference between the first one and the second one? The first one, the difference is, the first one you mention only one attribute of Allah, one ism al-A'am, which is Allah. أستغفر الله وأسأله التوبة. But the second one, you are mentioning five attributes of Allah. Five asma'ul husna. One is astaghfirullah. And then you come and say ar-Rahman, ar-Rahim. Then al-Hayy, al-Qayyum. Wa atubu ilayh. The first recommended tasbih in the month of Sha'ban is to do this istighfar. That is the first recommended things to do in the month of Sha'ban. The second one, the Prophet also recommended to do sadaqah. Sadaqah every month is important. Every month, right? Sadaqah is important. But in the month of Sha'ban, it's more important than the others. And you know this sadaqah wa ma adraka ma sadaqah. You go to the Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us in Surah Al-Munafiqun. Most of the people at the time of death, we realize the importance of sadaqah. But that time is too late. But Quran is telling us. What does he say? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-Kukah, in Surah Al-Munafiqun, he said, remember to give whatever Allah gave you before the time of death. وَأَنْفِقُوا مِمَّا رَزَقْنَاكُمْ مِنْ قَبْلِ أَنْ يَأْتِيَ أَحَدَكُمُ الْمَوْتِ فَيَقُولَ رَبِّ لَوْلَا أَخَّرْتَنِي إِلَىٰ أَجَلٍ قَرِيبٍ فَأَصَّدَّقْ وَأَكُنْ مِنَ الصَّالِحِينَ. At the time of death, the person will ask, Ya Rab, can I get some few minutes more? See, the ayah didn't say, فَأُصَلِّي, no. The ayah didn't say, فَأَحُجْ, but it's almost wajibat. فَأَكْرَعُ, no. فَأَصَّدَّقْ وَأَكُنْ مِنَ الصَّالِحِينَ. So I can give sadaqah. That is to tell you the importance of sadaqah. Not only that, you come to the Quran, not only Quran, the hadith of Imam. He said, in the month of Sha'ban, when they asked our sixth Imam, Imam Ja'far al-Sadiq alayhi salam.
Allahumma
salli ala Muhammad. Ma huwa afdalul a'mal fihi, ay fi shahr Sha'ban. What is the best thing? Quran, Salatul Layl, what is it? Then Imam says, afdalul a'mal fihi shay'an. The best thing to do in the month of Sha'ban is two things. What is it? Number one is al-istighfar wa sadaqah. To do istighfar and sadaqah. He said, how so? Then listen to the hadith of Imam, the sixth Imam. He says, man tasaddaqa fi, whoever do sadaqah in the month of Sha'ban, what happens? He said, rabbahu Allah. Allahu Akbar. Al-Rabbah man al-Tarbiyah. That sadaqah, Allah will nature it. Take care of it. Like when you plant a seed, right? And your aim is to become a tree, right? Now when the moment you plant it, you're giving it water. You're taking care of it. You make sure that no weeds comes around. You make sure that no wind comes and destroys. You take care of it. It's Rabbahu Allah. How long? Ila yawm al-qiyam. Not 1 year, not 10 years. Ila yawm al-qiyam. Right? Now, how will he take care of it? Then what? He said, hatta yuwafihi yawm al-qiyamah wa huwa ay sadaqa. He said, mithlu jabal Uhud. Allah nature that sadaqa and it grows to become like mountain of Uhud. Just sadaqa that you give in the month of Sha'ban. It's from the sixth Imam. And Allah didn't say, I'm going to let the angels to take care of it. Allah said, Rabbahu Allah. Allah said, I take care of that sadaqah and nature it for you. It's like, in other words, let me put it this way. It's like when you give sadaqah in the month of Sha'ban, it's like you are depositing in the account of Allah. And in that account, Allah says, and that account, there is something, here is haram, but in the side is halal, which is called what? Interest. Actually, when we go to the money, to the bank, we want interest, right? If I put $1,000, I want it to become 1,002. I want it to become 1,500. I want it to grow. Now, Allah, if you give sadaqah, it's like putting your money in my savings account, and how much is going to grow? Allah said, it will keep growing and growing till yawm al-qiyamah for you. Now Allah even told you in the Quran, مَثَلُ الَّذِينَ يُنْفِقُونَ أَمْوَالَهُمْ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ كَمَثَلِ حَبَّةٍ أَنْبَتَتْ سَبْعَ سَنَابِلٍ فِي كُلِّ سُنْبُلَةٍ مِئَةُ حَبَّةٍ. Allah tells you, even given for the sake of Allah, that is how much it has power. In this month, the recommended things is sadaqah. But when we say sadaqah, what do we mean? Sadaqah is not always about money. Sadaqah can be so many things. Quran can be sadaqah. I can read Fatiha or Surah from the Quran with the niyyah of sadaqah for a specific marhum. That's sadaqah too. It's recommended in the month of Sha'ban. I can perform two rakah prayer and the niyyah of sadaqah للمؤمنين المؤمنات للشهداء للعلماء. That also is taken as sadaqah as well. So you don't have to say, no, I don't have money. No. Everybody can do salat. Right? Now, I can't do salat, right? I cannot. Or you can fast also for the niyyah of sadaqah. I can't fast. Allahu Akbar. Smiling in the face of mu'min is sadaqah too. As long as the niyyah is qurbatan ila Allah. I look at a person who is going through difficulty, they're sad, they're going through some emotional problems, I put a smile on their face, qurbatan in Allah, that's considered sadaqah too. Sadaqah can be a lot of things. I bought slippers, I put in the bathroom, sadaqah, it gets there. I bought tasbih, I put in the masjid, sadaqah. I bought turbah, I put it in the masjid, it's considered sadaqah. And that's those things, these are little things, brothers, we all can do it. But the thawab is more than we can comprehend. That is the second thing we can do in the month of Sha'ban. Number three, as-salat. In the month of Sha'ban, there are specific salat that is recommended. One of them is a salat every Thursday night, only Thursdays. Ashiyat al-Khamis, the night of Thursday, after Salat al-Maghribain, you do two rakah prayer. Qurbatan ila Allah min a'mal ayyam Sha'ban. This two rakah, what do you read? One, you read Surah al-Fatiha and Surah al-Ikhlas 100 times. Surah al-Fatiha one time. Surah Al-Ikhlas, 100 times. No, I can't do 100 times. Okay, 50 times. I want more discount, 10 times. More discount, 3 times. But guess what? Here's the bottom line. Anybody who says 100 times, and the one who says 3 times, they're not gonna be equal. You have to get that. لا يستوي القاعدون على Mujahideen. It's not equal. Right? So I have a person who takes a time and read 100 times versus a person who read 2 times, 1 time, you have the whole salah. But the thawab is not the same. And you have to remember one thing also. لَن تَنَالُوا الْبِرَّ حَتَّى تُنْفِقُوا مِمَّا تُحِبُّونَ. If you want something from Allah, you have to give something to Allah. One of them is your time. That two rakah prayer, salat, one is Surah Al-Fatiha, the second is Surah Al-Ikhlas, 100 times.